Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. will hold talks with his U.S. counterpart Joe Biden in Washington as tensions in the West Philippine Sea grow. China sparked fresh concerns in the disputed waterway after its Coast Guard ship blocked a Philippine patrol vessel over a week ago. The visit also comes as the U.S. and the Philippines completed their largest war drills ever. In his pre-departure speech Sunday, Marcos said he hopes to forge stronger ties with the U.S. during his five-day visit.
We will reaffirm our commitment to fostering our long-standing alliance as an instrument of peace and as a catalyst of development in the Asia-Pacific region and, for that matter, the rest of the world. I intend to convey to President Biden and his senior cabinet officials that the President is determined to forge an even stronger relationship with the United States in a wide range of areas that not only address concerns of our times, but also those that are critical to advancing our core interests.
Meanwhile, Marcos says he already reached out to China regarding the latest incident in the West Philippine Sea. He adds he intends to have a high-level communication with China's officials to safeguard the country's maritime territory and secure the rights of Filipino fishermen.
Prior to President Marcos Jr.'s Washington visit, the U.S. expressed its support for the Philippines following China's latest aggression in the West Philippine Sea. The U.S. State Department called on China to stop its provocative and unsafe actions in Manila's maritime territory. It also assured the Philippines any armed attack on its armed forces, public vessels, or aircraft would invoke U.S. mutual defense commitments. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department has said it would file the appropriate diplomatic action over the incident.
The death toll from last week's collision between two foreign flag vessels off Corregidor Island rises to three. The body of the latest casualty, a Chinese crew member of one of the involved ships, was retrieved Saturday night. The two others who died were another Chinese crew member and a Filipino national. An investigation on the incident is underway.
At this point, hindi pa natin madetermine kung kasalanan ba nung tanker o kasalanan ng ungay. Sa investigation, of course, yung maneuver na ginawa nila, yung bukod doon sa maneuver, yung kanilang mga precautionary measures, tsaka yung kakayahan mo na ikaw yung mag-prevent ng collision.
Meanwhile, four individuals are missing after a dive yacht sank in the waters of Tubataha, Palawan.
Over now to conflict hit Sudan. Sounds of heavy gunfire echoed throughout the Sudanese capital Khartoum on Sunday, despite an agreed truce. Now this as Sudan's military factions accuse each other of committing ceasefire violations. The fighting, which has been running for more than 2 weeks now, has killed hundreds of people and wounded thousands. On Thursday, the warring sides agreed on a ceasefire that was supposed to last until Sunday.
Meanwhile, the International Committee of the Red Cross sends vital medical aid to Sudan. The humanitarian cargo weighing 8 tons includes surgical materials such as anesthetics, dressings, and sutures. The organization's Africa Operations Director calls for guarantees of safe passage to deliver the much-needed aid.
After the 14th of April, no one has managed to get medical assistance into the country, which is badly needed. This medical assistance will hopefully travel quite quickly from Port Sudan, delivered to the hospitals that are in most need. And that requires indeed a ceasefire that should be respected by both sides for us to be able, with our colleagues from the Sudanese Red Crescent, to deliver these items as quickly as we can to the hospitals and allow the medical personnel, doctors and nurses, but also first aid volunteers to do their job. Because for now, they are, as much as they're trying, people are extremely disappointed because no one, unfortunately, is able to build a strong humanitarian response as it needed. Since the 14th of April, the number of casualties has only increased because the fighting is happening in densely populated area in a capital of 6 million people.
Repatriation efforts still ongoing for Filipinos in conflict-torn Sudan. The Foreign Affairs Department says more than 400 Filipinos have secured a visa entry to Egypt. 114 more have left Khartoum and are on their way to the Egyptian border. The agency says they will be brought to Cairo and will wait for their flight back to the Philippines there.
We were able to book all of them hotel rooms. So in four hotels in Cairo, so makakapagpahinga sila at last. Grabe ang pinagdaanan nila. The desert became their toilet, ano, while in the immigration facilities.
At least 17 Filipinos, meanwhile, arrived home Saturday. Among them are eight hotel workers who escaped the conflict with the help of a Greek military aircraft, while nine others came from Saudi Arabia. The DFA says there are over 700 Filipinos in Sudan, but some of them decided not to go home.
So we're thinking there's still about 100 to 140 Filipinos na nandun pa, na hindi pa naman din nagsisignify ng intention nila na ma-repatriate.